翁岛灯塔坐落在澎湖县西屿乡，也被叫做西屿灯塔。它是台湾第一座现代式灯塔，也是唯一一座至今仍沿用传统机械装置的灯塔。公元1874年，由英国人韩德森在拆除旧塔的基础上建成，塔身700，塔高11米，内有螺旋铁制楼梯。园区内立有西屿塔灯碑记、雾笛和三座铁柱雾炮，用于在大雾天气时发射警示讯号。Stephen Davis 教授出生于航海世家，对渔翁岛灯塔的历史以及灯塔内部的机械原理有着深刻的研究。
This light it has two focal lenses. They're 6 seconds apart. If you time the light, it takes 30 seconds to go around a complete circle. And in that 30 seconds, it flashes twice because you've got these two lenses. You've got this bevel gear that turns it through right angles into another bevel gear inside the housing here that goes through right angles down into the main mechanism, which is down here. And that drum is unrolling very slowly. The wire is going down like this, translating that very slow creep into the fast drive that you can see winding the light around. And how that's done is that on the end of the wire, there's a big lead weight, which you can adjust. It's made of plates of lead, and you can put as many plates on until you get the wire going down at exactly the right rate. So the whole thing is quite complicated to calibrate. When you first fit it all up, the wire hasn't stretched. So gradually...
these cheap and easy guns for the insurers to be satisfied and give you a new premium. My guess is that these were probably ex-pirate cannon, which had been thrown overboard when a patrol came up, and somebody has found them and put them in place there on a mound that may well originally have been used for the fog cannon. On this side, it's just a little tower thing. On the other side, it's two things like a loudspeaker. That's a modern electromechanical foghorn. Basically, it works like a big loudspeaker. You've got a diaphragm vibrating in the back, and that booms out a signal. I don't know how many horns.
渔翁岛灯塔的机械构造至今仍保存完好，虽然古老，却十分实用。
渔翁岛是最古老的灯塔，现在目前唯一还是用手盘上去的，大齿轮带动小齿轮这样。传统的方式它是零故障，它故障率很低。你现在先进的这些电子方面，它故障率很高，所以还是原来传统的保持这个机械原理这个比较好。
传统的机械装置能够沿用至今，离不开一代代守塔人的坚守。守塔人需24小时轮流看管，每隔3小时盘灯一次。除此之外，他们还要观测气象和记录来往船只，在恶劣的天气里为远航的轮船发出危险信号。灯塔远离当地社区，守塔人要面对的通常是重复单调的生活。无数个夜晚，一人与一塔相伴，这是一代代守塔人对历史的坚守，也是对航海人的责任。
这个灯塔都在离岛啊，都在不是很热闹的地方啦、啊，不是孤岛，就是在那个没有热闹的地方啦、啊。
守塔工作虽然单调，却是灯塔家族最珍贵的回忆。
爸爸是在灯塔工作，那所以从小 从小就在灯塔长大，灯塔就等于是我们的游乐场。嘿，那前面那块草皮就是我们打棒球的地方，好啊，那个炮台就是我们溜滑梯的地方，好啊，前面那一块更大的草皮就是我们踢足球的地方，好啊。外面有个十字，那个小女孩的墓，对不对？那个是我们看夕阳的地方，好啊。反正整个灯塔就是我们的游乐园这样子。
百年以前，渔翁岛灯塔塔手均由外籍人士担任，他们漂洋过海来到这座离岛，与灯塔一起守护着这片海域，有些人甚至长眠于此。
If you look at the grave, there's this cross that faces over there, and on the seaward side, so facing away from the lighthouse. Right here on this beautifully mown, clipped lawn, looking out over the sea, there's just one prominent feature: this gravestone.It reads, in memory of Nellie O'Driscoll, 1890. Who was Nellie O'Driscoll? All we know is that she was Christian, it's a cross, and that she was related to the lighthouse keeper, Thomas O'Driscoll. Was she a wife? Was she a daughter? Was she Chinese? Was she European? We don't know the answer to any of that.We just think it's probable that she was Chinese. Nellie was a common name given by Western lighthouse keepers to their Chinese wives. And she's buried looking exactly west towards Xiamen, China, her home.
先进的电子海图和卫星定位并没有取代传统的灯塔导航。
电子海图，你说它准，它很准；你说它就有时候就会有意外，所以你除了这个之外，你还一定要有目视，除了灯塔，你要导航。
于船长今年59岁，有着30多年的航海经验。
因为这个灯塔它有它的光线啊，这灯塔这一分钟它有几下啊，它闪几下，它上面都有灯光性质都有。如果这灯光性质你认为是对的。它这个灯塔一直站在这个位置。
海洋、船舶、灯塔已经成为他生命中的一部分。澎湖人民傍海为生，渔翁岛灯塔为当地渔民指引航向，安定航海人漂泊的心。
那早期啊，灯塔也是我们当地渔民渔船，它整个回乡靠港的一个方向的一个辨别。那其实在早期最大的建筑物就是灯塔，最明显的就是灯塔，那也是我们整个一个精神上的一个象征的一个地标。
但对我来说，我从小住在都市里面，我只能在书本上看到，我实际碰不到，因为过去那段时间灯塔是被禁止参观的，是不可以去接触的。那最近是因为管理上的这个管理权的转移，所以慢慢我们可以开放，让我们民众去接触灯塔，去了解灯塔。不过现在目前就灯塔来说，我们一般民众只是去参观，他并没有办法去很深入了解灯塔的过去的那段辉煌的历史。先让他们喜欢这个地方这个氛围，然后他们再去探索它，那可能会对这方面的保存跟去维护会有帮助。
塔是陆地的尽头，海洋的起点。作为台湾最古老的灯塔，渔翁岛灯塔历经风雨，依然守护着这片海域。它持续绽放光芒，为过往船只照亮前进的方向。